What's up, guys? Nick McDonald here.
Bitch, this is fame, not clout. I don't even know what that's about. Watch your mouth. Baby got an ego twice the size of the crib. I can never tell a shit.
We're back with another video, and today I wanted to jump right into the second wave of stimulus checks. What's being negotiated in Washington between Democrats and Republicans, and if we're even going to get them. Hell, I know some people didn't even get the first check. But before we get into all that, I need you to go ahead and smash the like or subscribe button for me. That way I can keep bringing you weekly content on finance or investing. So yesterday, May 12th, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi unveiled a massive $3 trillion coronavirus relief bill that's going to be voted on by the House this Friday. The bill, which spans more than 1,800 pages, is known as the Health and Economic Recovery Omnibus Emergency Solutions Act, or HEROES Act. Here's a rundown of some of the highlights. Assistance to state and local governments. The bill is going to provide $500 billion in direct assistance to state governments to counter the fiscal impacts of the pandemic, $375 billion to assist local governments, and $20 billion to tribal governments and $20 billion to U.S. territories. It's going to establish $200 billion for the HEROES Fund to ensure that essential workers receive hazard pay. Their employers would be able to apply for grants to provide $13 per hour premium pay for their workers on top of regular wages. These employers would be eligible for grants of $10,000 per worker or $5,000 for highly compensated essential workers. It would also provide an extension of unemployment benefits. The proposal would extend a $600 per week boost in unemployment insurance established under the CARES Act until January 2021 to help millions who have lost jobs during the pandemic. Wait, a $600 a week raise in unemployment wages from now until January? Hell yeah!
The bill would also extend existing student loan payment plans established in the CARES Act, which didn't cover private loan borrowers. It would provide up to $10,000 in debt relief to be applied to a private student loan to be paid in monthly installments by the Treasury Department until September of 2021. Also, an additional $75 billion for coronavirus testing, contact tracing, and isolation measures. Now let's get to the good part. Direct payments to Americans. The bill would implement a second round of direct payments, meaning second stimulus check, to Americans to assist with the fallout of the pandemic. It would provide $1,200 to every family member, including children. So that's a significant raise in the first round of stimulus checks, which paid $500 per child. This new bill would pass $1,200 per child, up to $6,000 per household, and a maximum of three children. So if you have five kids, you're not going to get $1,200 for five kids. Only $1,200, up to three children. The HEROES Act gives $25 billion in assistance to the Postal Service, which is expected to run out of money by late September without congressional assistance.
So basically, in a nutshell, we should all cross our fingers and pray to God that this bill is passed on Friday, because it could be great for millions of Americans, and a lot better than that first stimulus, I can tell you that much. And I was especially glad to see that this bill is going to take better care of parents and essential frontline workers. I'm a parent myself, and knowing that I'm going to get $1,200 from my daughter instead of $500, that goes a long way. And to all the frontline workers out there, you guys definitely deserve it. You guys have kept the country afloat pretty much the last 2 months. Stocking ourselves with supplies, delivering our food and mail, bagging our groceries. You've pretty much risked your life so that the country can survive as a whole. I cannot commend you enough. And now knowing that you're going to get an extra $13 on top of what you already make, that's going to help a lot of people sleep better at night. I can't believe the companies you work for didn't even want to pay additional hazard pay. That's so disrespectful. So we'll see how it all plays out over the next 48 hours, because this bill could be a huge make it or break it moment for a lot of Americans. And while we're waiting on that, you might as well just smash the like or subscribe button, or drop your comments down below. Later.